Good morning, dear students. So we'll continue our nucleophilic substitution reaction in this class, but with a new concept and with a special reagent. So let me take the reagents now. Potassium cyanide is the reagent for nucleophilic substitution reaction. In this case, cyanide ion is the nucleophile. Cyanide ion is the nucleophile. When this cyanide ion attacks the alkyl group in RX, alkyl halides, so what you will get? So this will, you will attack this one, it will, and you will get R. C is attacking triple bond N, RCN plus, you are getting Kx. You are getting Kx as the byproduct. Okay, so such compounds are called cyanides. Cyanides, or they are also called nitrides. Cyanides are nitrides. Okay, when our alkyl halide reacts with KCl, potassium cyanide, the cyanide ion will be the nucleophile. We know that potassium cyanide dissociates to give potassium ion and cyanide ion. This cyanide ion becomes the nucleophile, and this nucleophile will attack the R and we will get RCN product. Such type of compound, the RCN type of compounds are called cyanides. If R is methyl group, it is methyl cyanide. If R is ethyl, it is ethyl cyanide, etc. So this is regarding the reaction between our alkyl halide and potassium cyanide. So I will take one more example of silver cyanide. In this case, we have taken potassium cyanide. In this case, we are taking silver cyanide. So you might be thinking that in the case of silver cyanide, cyanide ion may be the nucleophile. If you are thinking so, so that is wrong. Because silver cyanide being a polar compound predominantly, it will not dissociate to give Ag plus ions and cyanide ions. As in the case of potassium cyanide dissociates to give K plus Cn minus, and this Cn minus is the nucleophile in the case of KCl. But this is not true in the case of silver cyanide. So we cannot expect this silver cyanide to undergo dissociation to give Ag plus and Cn minus. So this is not the case, because it is predominantly silver cyanide bond is a covalent. It is predominantly a covalent bond between silver and the cyanide ion. Therefore, it will not undergo dissociation. In this case, silver cyanide itself is the nucleophile. Please remember, AgCn itself is the nucleophile. In the case of KCl, cyanide ion is the nucleophile, because KCl is an ionic compound, it dissociates to give K plus ion and Cn minus ion. But in the case of silver cyanide, it is predominantly a covalent bond. Therefore, no dissociation of silver cyanide. Therefore, silver cyanide itself is the nucleophile. Please remember, we have two electrons on the nitrogen. So what will be the product? So what will be the product here? So you are getting R. So which atom is attacking? In this case, it is the carbon which attacks the R. But in this case, carbon is bonded to silver, which is the free atom. It is the nitrogen. Nitrogen atom will attack the R. Therefore, R gets bonded to N. Then we have triple bond C. So after the nitrogen attacks the R alkyl group, so after that the silver gets detached from the carbon atom. Now we'll have AgX. AgX. After nitrogen gets attached to R, the silver gets detached from the carbon. Now we will have RNC. Here RCN, cyanide. Here RNC. N is attached to R in this case. Carbon is attached to R in this case. RCN compounds are called cyanides. RNC compounds are called isocyanides. Isocyanides or isonitrides. Isonitrides. See, we are dealing with the same type of reagents, right? Here it is potassium cyanide, here it is silver cyanide. But we are dealing with two different products. In the first case, we are getting alkyl cyanides or nitrile compounds. In the second case, we are getting isocyanides or isonitriles. So this is because one reagent is ionic and dissociates to give cyanide ions. In case of cyanide nucleophile, carbon is the one which attacks the alkyl group and will get cyanides. In the case of a polar or a covalent compound like silver cyanides, so no dissociation, the whole molecule itself is the nucleophile. Now carbon will not attack the R, it is the nitrogen, it is the lone pair of electrons of nitrogen which attacks the alkyl group, and nitrogen is the atom which gets bonded to alkyl group and will get the compound of the type RNC, which are called isocyanides or isonitriles. So such type of nucleophiles are called ambidentate nucleophile. Such cyanide is an ambidentate nucleophile. Ambidentate nucleophiles. You have to study the concept of ambidentate nucleophiles. What are ambidentate nucleophiles? The nucleophiles which contain more than one nucleophilic centers are called ambidentate nucleophiles. Example is our cyanide. So if I write the structure of cyanide ion, okay, so this is the structure and so the resonance structure, its resonance structure is C double bond N minus. Okay, so the cyanide ion mainly exists as these two structures. So here we have a negatively charged carbon which attacks the alkyl group in this case, and the negative charge is also present on the nitrogen, but so in comparison with this structure, so this structure predominantly attack the R group and carbon gets attached to R and you get cyanides. So if the carbon is not free, as in the case of silver cyanide, the carbon is not free. Carbon doesn't contain negative charge to attack alkyl group. In this case, the nitrogen becomes the nucleophilic center. The lone pair of electrons of nitrogen becomes the nucleophilic center, and the nitrogen will attack the R group and you will get isocyanates. So in this case, carbon is the nucleophilic center. In this case, nitrogen is the nucleophilic center. Such type of nucleophiles like cyanide ions, which contain more than one nucleophilic center, are called ambidentate nucleophile. Another example for ambidentate nucleophile is nitrite group. These nitrite groups. So, if I take potassium nitrite, KNO3. So, if I try to react this potassium nitrite, NO2, so potassium nitrite, of course, we know that this is an ionic compound and it dissociates to give O-N double bond O minus. Here, what is the nucleophilic center? Oxygen is the nucleophilic center. So, this oxygen will attack the R group of our alkali, and what we will get is R-O-N double bond O. So, such compounds are called alkyl nitrites. Alkyl nitrites. Alkyl nitrites. If we take silver nitrite, NO2, silver nitrite, just in the case of potassium cyanide and silver cyanide, we have potassium nitrite and silver nitrite. We know that potassium nitrite is ionic compound. It will dissociate. When it gets dissociated, we will get O-N double bond O, and the oxygen carrying a negative charge, and the oxygen is the nucleophilic center. This oxygen will attack the alkyl group and X gets substituted. We will get R-O-N double bond O. This type of compounds are called alkyl nitrites. Now let us see what happens when the same alkyl halide is treated with silver nitrite. We know that silver nitrate is predominantly a covalent compound. No dissociation of silver and nitrite group. Here Ag O single bond N double bond O is itself. So this is the structure of AgNO2. Here no dissociation takes place, no breaking of silver oxygen bond. Therefore, now can you guess the nucleophilic center in this case? Here it is the lone pair of electrons. It is the lone pair of electrons of nitrogen which attacks our alkyl group. In this case, which atom is attacking? Oxygen atom is attacking. In this case, the oxygen atom doesn't carry negative charge because no breaking of silver oxygen bond, because it is covalent in nature. We know that covalent bonds do not undergo dissociation. the whole molecule itself is the nucleophile in this case. Now the lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen becomes the nucleophilic center and it will attack R. Now can you guess the compound product? We have R. So which atom gets attached now? Nitrogen is the one which gets attached to the alkyl group. Now we have R minus double bond O. This is the product. So such compounds are called nitroalkanes. Nitroalkanes. So the first one is alkyl nitrite and the second one is nitroalkanes. So the nitro group is also ambidentate nucleophile. Ambidentate nucleophile. So what are ambidentate nucleophiles? The nucleophiles having more than one nucleophilic center. In the case of potassium nitrite, oxygen is the nucleophilic center. In the case of silver nitrite, nitrogen is the nucleophilic center. In the first case, oxygen is the nucleophilic center. In the second case, nitrogen is the nucleophilic center. Such type of nucleophiles having more than one nucleophilic centers are called ambidentate nucleophiles. The same groups, nitrate group, here potassium nitrate, here silver nitrate, but the products are different. The same cyanide, potassium cyanide, silver cyanide, the products are different. Okay, so this is very much important, my dear students. The concept of ambidentate nucleophiles and the type of product you get from these reagents is of paramount importance. So with this, we are completing the nucleophilic substitution reactions. So we'll stop at this stage, my dear students. Thank you very much for your cooperation in this online courses. Thank you, dear parents.